Hey guys, good morning, good afternoon, good evening. In this video, I'll show you how to create your own transcription software using OpenAI's Whisper API and Bubble.io. If you know nothing about coding and programming, don't worry, we are not going to use any kind of coding or programming in this video, I promise. So our interface is going to look like this. Here, the users will come and upload their MP3 files or any kind of audio file. Then they will press this transcribe button. And within a second, they will have the transcription text. So pretty simple stuff, pretty clean interface. And what we are going to achieve is, first, we are going to build our interface using Bubble.io. Bubble.io is a no-code editor. If you know nothing about Bubble.io, don't worry, it's not a rocket science. Pretty simple stuff. And then we'll connect our OpenAI's Whisper API with Bubble in the backend. And then we will build our workflow so the interface and the Whisper API can talk to each other. So this is going to be pretty simple. We are not going to use any kind of programming language or any kind of coding. So first, we are going to build our interface. Let's go to Bubble Editor and start building our interface. So go to this website, bubble.io. And this is a no-code editor, so you can create your softwares without any kind of coding. A lot of big companies using Bubble also. So if you have an account, log in with your account. If you don't have an account, click on get started and just log in with your Google account. So I have an account, so I log in. Then I will click log in with Google and I'll log in with my Google account. All right, we are going to create an web app using OpenAI's Whisper API. So we'll click on create an app and we are going to name it something Whisper API Pro. All right, this name is available. So this is going to be our URL. You can add your own URL also. You can charge your users also using this software. So create an app. All right, after that, we are going to skip application assistant. We don't need that because I'm going to assist you. Okay, so this is our interface, but this is completely blank. So let's preview it. So as you can see, this is completely blank. So first, we need a file uploader, then we need a transcribe button, and then we'll need a text box to show the transcription text. So first go to input forms and click on file uploader and just drag and drop. And let me arrange. And from here, you can assign your file size. I'm going to make it 100 MB. And let's edit the style a bit. I'll change the border style to dotted and width to 2. And font size to 80 so that you can see. So let's go to design again. So this is our uploader. So user can upload their files here. So let me show you what it looks like. Click on preview. As you can see, here is our uploader. If I'll click on this, it will, I can upload my file from here. So let's go to our editor again, and we need a button. So click the button and drag and drop. And let's arrange this to center. Let's rename the button to transcribe. And I would like to change the button color. So from here, I'll click on this and go to edit styles, and I'll change the background color to something like this. And I will also change the font size to 18 so that you can see it. So let's go to design again. And let's refresh our page. Okay, we have a file uploader. Then we have a transcribe button. So one thing we need from here is a text box where the transcribe, where the transcription text will appear. So let's close this, and we need a text box. Click on the text box and just drag and drop. Let's arrange this to center and let's edit the style, font size 18, borders solid, and 2, then go to layout. I would like to put a bit padding here. All right. Let's go to design again. Let's see how it looks. Well, this looks good. Let's refresh our main page. All right. User will upload their file here and then they will click transcribe, and the transcription text will appear here within a second or two. And we are going to use OpenAI's Whisper API for that. Our interface is done. Now let's connect our Whisper API. So go to plugin, click on add plugins, and then install the API connector. All right. Then click done. Then click add another API. So we are going to name this OpenAI and authorization. Make it to private key in the header. All right. So then go to the Whisper API documentation. You can find this on OpenAI's website and just grab this one because we need this for authorization. Bearer, then your OpenAI's API key. So I'm going to add this. And I will replace this with my OpenAI's API key. So let me create a secret key. You can log in with your OpenAI account and click on view API keys. Then you can click to create another API key and you can just copy it. And so let me replace my API key. And we are done with this. So let's expand it, and we are going to make it Whisper, and we'll make it action because we are going to trigger an action using our transcribe button, and this will be post. And here we are going to put this call. All right, and we are going to add our header. So content type. And then multi-part form data. All right. So body type will not be JSON, because we are going to use form data. Form data means our user is going to upload a file. So we need to add two more parameters. Let's add one parameter here and one parameter here. Let's uncheck this. And first one is the model. Model is, and second one is the file, I think. Yeah, this is a file. So here we are going to send a file to OpenAI's Whisper so that it can transcribe that file for us. So I'll click on send file. All right. And as you can see, the value is reset to upload. And for this, we need to put Whisper 1. All right. Whisper 1. All right. Let's test it. I want to show you that I already have an MP3 recorded. Let's listen to it. Hey guys, in this video, I'll show you how to create an image using Microsoft Paint. We are going to transcribe this MP3. So before you start using OpenAI's Whisper API, you need to initialize a call. So I'll click on upload and click on this MP3. That will be uploaded. Let me check everything is correct or not. Yeah, it seems correct. Let's initialize the call. All right, as you can see, we have some text value here. OpenAI's Whisper API successfully transcribed our text. Let's see the text. Hey guys, in this video, I'll show you create an image using Microsoft Paint. All right, this is a success for us. So if you like this, please like the video. And next, we are going to build our workflow. So let's save it. Let's go to design. Okay, we have an upload button here. We have upload button here. We have a transcribe button here. And we have our text. So when we'll upload a file, we are going to send it to Whisper API. All right. But when? When the user will hit transcribe, then the value which Whisper API will return, we are going to reflect that here, the transcribed text. So let's get started. Okay, this is our file uploader. So, okay. And this is our transcribe button. And this is our, so let's rename it. So let's click on our transcribe button and just double click. And click start or edit the workflow. So the workflow will take it directly. So let's click here to add an action. Our action going to be OpenAI and then the Whisper call. So right now the dynamic link is S3 Amazon AWS. But we are going to set it to our dynamic value of the file uploader. All right. So when our user will upload the file, it will take the value, whatever the value is, whatever the file is, it will take that and it will give it to Whisper API. So before that, let me show you something. Bubble doesn't add HTTPS, so you have to add it manually. All right. So you have to add the HTTPS manually here. Let's add a dynamic value. So before that, let me add HTTPS. HTTPS. Let's insert the dynamic value of our file uploader. All right. This is our file uploader A. All right. And we are going to add this value. So every time the user will upload a file, this will take this value. So click here. And we are going to change the state of our index page. And element our index page. And in that state, we are going to store our transcribed text. I'm doing this because in the following videos, I will show you how to translate those text. We can also set a state of that text box, but we are going to set the state of the index page. Let me create a custom state and transcribed text. This is my custom state, and the value or the state type will be text because we are going to store the text here. So let's click create. And here we need the value what Whisper's API will provide us. So click on this and click on result of step one. And we are going to fetch the text value. All right. And one thing is remaining. We are going to put this value to our text box. So let's go to design and click on this. And after that, we need to add a dynamic value. So our dynamic value will be index transcribed text. All right. And I think we are done. Let's preview it. Let me upload a file. I'm uploading the same file. And let's send it to Whisper's API and let's see what happens. All right. We got our transcribed text. So please subscribe to this channel because I am going to make a lot of videos like this. See you in the next video. Thank you so much for appreciating my work.